Hi all, this is Dr. Asrar. In this video I am going to talk about decision analysis. Hope you all are fine and enjoying the COVID-19 holidays, right? Yes, let us go to the class. So what this chapter deals with, this is the first video on decision analysis. I'll just talk about the concepts, then we'll see how to do it in Excel. Okay. Any doubts, any queries you have, you can comment or you can come into WhatsApp group. I'll surely try to clarify that. Okay, let's start. What is decision analysis? Decision analysis is an analytic and systematic way to tackle problems. So in a business, a manager has to take a decision, and the decision should be based on logic. So any decision which is based on logic is a good decision. The success and failure that a person experiences in life depend on decision that he or she makes. So there are some methods how to analyze the decision and take alternative and the best decision. Okay, so this chapter we are going to talk about which is best decision and how do we do that. Okay. These are the five top steps which we have to consider while decision making. First, we have to define the clear problem at hand. What is the problem? And then list the possible decision alternative. You have a problem and list down all the possible alternatives which you can do for your business. Okay. Identify the possible future outcomes for each decision. Okay. You have to identify what would be the outcome. And you have to also identify the most important thing, that is payoff. So what out of each alternative, what is the payoff you get from each of the alternative outcomes? Then after comparing all the alternatives, you have to select the best one from that alternatives. Okay, let us see a simple case of Kumar Corrugated Sheets Manufacturing Company. Okay, the manager is Shiva, the founder is Shiva, okay, and he's the president of Kumar Sheets Manufacturing Company, which is located in Chennai, Oragadam. Okay, a fictional example. So the case is Shiva has to take decision on to expand his business by three alternative choices. First alternative choice is he can build a large plant. Okay, he has to take a decision on whether to go for a large plant or to go for a small plant. Or better not to build any plant and just stay simple without any investment. So when he goes for a large plant, by considering there will be high demand and there will be high payoff. If he builds a small plant, by considering there will be a moderate demand and moderate payoff. And if he builds no plant and just go like how the profit is coming. So his financier gives a three alternative outcome. That is, if Kumar Sheets company goes for a large plan, if there is a high demand, there will be a profit of 2 lakhs. Okay. If there is a moderate demand, there will be a profit of 1 lakh. And in case if there is a demand is very low, then they will end up in loss of 1,20,000. If Kumar Sheets goes for a small plan, which will yield, in case of high demand, it will have a profit of 90,000. In case of moderate demand, it will have a profit of 50,000. And if the demand is low, it will end up in 20,000 loss. So Kumar Sheets has one more option, third option, that is no plan. Okay, there is no need to build any plan. So all these three, in these three cases, there will be no profit, no loss. It will be zero. Okay, so now there is a method to, as per the steps which we have seen here, the five step decision making, to define the problem. Now the problem is whether to expand the manufacturing firm, the Kumar Sheets manufacturing firm, or not. That is the step one he has to define. And as I said, step two, decision alternative. There are three decisions which Kumar can do. One is build a large plant. Second option is build a small plan, and decision 3 is build no plan. Fine. Now the third outcome is, the third point is, he has to identify the possible outcome. As we saw here, if he goes for the large plant, okay, the high demand, in case of high demand there will be 2 lakhs profit, in case of low demand there will be a loss of 120. Okay, thus all possible outcomes we have to list it down. Then the fourth step is compare the list of payoffs. What would be the payoffs? This is what the payoff we saw, right? This is the payoff, and we have to compare and choose the best one. And now, how do I choose the best one? So these are the 5 steps which explains in Kumar Sheth's case. Okay, now how do I take the best decision? There are 3 decision making environment which every manager faces in his life. Okay, the first one is taking a decision under certainty. Certainty means what? Certainty is nothing but you know exactly what is going to be your outcome. Okay, decision under uncertainty, you may not know what will be the future events when you are taking a decision. It may end up in a high successfulness or it may end up in low success. Okay, it's completely uncertain. And decision under risk. The best example for decision under risk would be dealing with an ace card from a deck of cards. Okay, you know exactly there are 13 ace cards. Okay, in that cards game. So what is the probability of getting 1/13? You know there is a risk, you may end up in 0, but still you know there are 13 cards. So decision maker have some knowledge regarding the probability of occurrence. So that kind of decision is called decision under risk. Okay, now how many types of decision making under uncertainty? So these are the types. First one is called Maximax, then Maximin, criterion of realism, which is in other words called Howard's method, and equally likely, which is called Laplace criterion, and Minimax regulator. So these are the different types of decision making done under uncertainty. So let us look one by one. First one, Maximax. Maximax is a completely an optimistic approach. As we see the Kumar Sheth's example, the maximum payoff, the maximum profit which he can get is through building a large plan in case of high demand. So you will go for a maximum alternative decision. So if you consider under Maximax decision, it's a highly optimistic approach. So if you apply this method, your decision would be to go for a large plan. Okay, this is a criterion that selects the decision alternative that maximizes the maximum payoffs of all the alternatives. Second method, it is the opposite of Maximax. It is called pessimistic approach, which takes the minimum of all the alternatives. For example, from this Kumar Sheth's payoffs, you can see the minimum payoffs in the all three alternative is 0. So as per this method, you will go with a very low risk and 0 profit, 0 payoff. That is why it is called pessimistic approach. The third criteria of decision making is called criterion of realism. In other words, it is also called Howick's approach. Here, the weighted average approach, it is based on weighted average approach. Okay, there's a formula given here, realism payoff, alpha into maximum payoff for alternative, plus 1 minus alpha into minimum payoff of alternative. According to criterion of realism rule, the decision criterion offers compromise between optimistic and pessimistic decision. Okay, it takes the neutral stand between highly optimistic and pessimistic decision, and based on this formula. Let us see this example. As we all know, this is the case of Kumar Sheth's. Okay, this will be the payoffs. So we have to give a weightage. If you give alpha value 1, then you are highly optimistic person. okay, you are expecting a high demand and you want the maximum out of your decision. Okay, if it is a 0.5, then it means that you are a neutral person. If you consider alpha as 0, then it means that you are a totally pessimistic decision and you want to go for a minimum risk. As per in this example, we have taken a 0.45 alpha value, okay, which is just next to the neutral person, slightly towards pessimistic, a 5% towards pessimistic, okay, 45%. So based on this, use this formula and calculate, and out of these three, which is the maximum? Maximum is to build a smart plan. So if you go according to this criterion, then we'll go for to build a small plan. Okay, the fourth one, equally likely Laplace criterion. It is also called Laplace criterion. Okay, this is very simple. It takes the average, highest average of alternative. Look at here. What is the case of building a large plan? 2 lakhs, 1 lakhs and minus 120. Just add this all and divide it by 3, you will get 60,000. We have to take the average of payoffs. Average of payoffs for small plan, what is the average of payoff? And for the no plan, what is the average of payoff? Then finally, in this 3, which is the highest payoff? The highest payoff, average payoff is 60,000. So according to equally likely Laplace criterion method, a decision maker will go for a building a. Let us see the fifth one, which is called Minimax. It's also called regret criterion. Here it is completely based on the opportunity loss. According to this method, it finds the alternative that minimizes the maximum opportunity loss within each alternative. For example, the best payoff with high demand in Kumar Sheth's payoff table is 2 lakhs. So that 2 lakhs will be subtracted or say deducted from that particular column. For example, like this, you have to first draw the opportunity loss table. Okay, so as per this one, you have to draw this thing from this build large plan, which is the maximum. The maximum is 2 lakhs. So subtract 2 lakhs with this entire column. Okay, then from this second moderate thing, you have to select as we saw the first one here, as per this column, the 2 lakhs was the highest. Second column, which is the highest, 1 lakh was the highest, so subtract with 1 lakh. And in case of low demand, which is the maximum? Maximum is this no plan, 0, rest all are in minus. So you have to minus this all. Then finally, for opportunity loss table, you have to sum this, and then finally you get this result, and you have to take the minimum of this alternative. The minimum of this alternative is what? 1,10,000. Okay, so this is based on Minimax regret criterion method. So that's it for 5 types of methods. Okay, just a small recap. We are dealing with decision analysis. Okay, so these are the 5 steps of decision making, and we saw the case of Kumar Sheets. These are the outcomes. There are 5 steps. First, we have to define the problem, then decision alternatives, then identify the possible outcome, compare the list of payoffs, select the best and apply. Types of decision making under making environment. There are 3 environments, as I said. And what are the different types of decision making? These are the methods of decision making: Maximax, Maximin, Minimax regret, equal likely, criterion of realism. So as we saw, just go through the slides. If you have a questions, please comment on the comment box, and take care of yourself and stay safe. Thank you.